Today in this video session, we will discuss how to configure YUM locally. Okay, so this is my Linux 6, which OS I have installed over VMware Workstation 11. On above that, I am going to do YUM configuration locally. So first, let me open the terminal. Maximize it. Come to root. Here, let me check IP configuration done or not. IP is not there, right? So let me set a static IP. So we can go for setup, then go for network configuration. Then device configuration, Ethernet 0, just uncheck it, give one IP here, 192.168.0.1, I'll give, so, come here, save it, quit. Now, if config it is 192.168.0.1, let me off it. Sorry. Let me off it is 0 nick as well. What is saying error? Connection activation failed, device not managed by network manager. Well, so we need to stop network manager service. Then only we can make nick. So how will stop? Service network manager stop. Now I can make off NIC. So now let's check if config. So now I am getting IP, right? I want to give this IP as permanent basis. I will give /etc config network scripts if chg eth0 enter. Here it's already been there, right? I'll give you on boot, yes. So when my next reboot, this IP will take automatic. So let me save it. Now done. Now I am getting this IP. Now we'll go for the YUM configuration part as local. Before that, I just need to check whether my DVD drive is there or not. I will check by executing df-h. My DVD drive is not there. So what I will do here, just right click on virtual machine and then click on setting. Then click on CD DVD. Here you just need to check the connector and then click on OK. So now it's mounted. Last one. Right. This is my DVD. So what I will do here, let it be like that. Not required to touch anything else. Okay. So let it be like that. What we will do here, we will just create a dump for that OS, and that by taking that dump, we will create a repo. Okay. And that repo we will configure local. This is where the funda, nothing else. So let me go ahead for further. What we need to do before, make sure when you are going to do YUM configuration either locally or over the FTP server. Before that, you just need to install 4 RPM packages. Which RPM packages? Let me enter media, then RHCL, then execute ls, so that you will come to know the packages. Under packages only, packages will be there. So this is my all the packages. Here I need to install, I mentioned four packages, right? So when you are going to install any RPM packages, that time we need to execute the command is rpm-ivh and that particular package name, right? So this is what the way to install a package. Let me do that, rpm-ivh, and I want to install here delta rpm. Before hit enter key, let me mention this thing. What is this ivh? Okay, most of the time interviewer are asking, what is the use of I, what is the use of V, what is the use of H? It's nothing but I for install, V for verbose, H for, you can say, return has. Okay, so for this purpose only we are using IVH. However it is, I want to install this delta rpm package. Now hit enter key. Now this is done. How I'll get confirmation whether this delta rpm package installation has been done or not? We can query that. How will query by rpm? rpm-qa and dltarpm. Hit enter key. It will show that package. See, now that package is showing here. It means that package installation done. Now we'll install rpm-ivh python delta. Python delta rpm. This is also done. I will check by rpm-qa python delta rpm. We no need to type completely. We just need to give that name. That is enough. So now this installation also done. Now I want to install rpm-ivh create repo. Create repo. What it will do? It will create repo. So this is also done. I will check QA create repo. This is also done. Now I just need to install rpm-ivh vsftpd. Sorry. I will check rpm-qa vsftpd. It will show. Let me clear the screen. Let me come to four. So now my four RPM package installation done. Which package is required for yum configuration? It means before start yum configure, we need to install these four RPM packages. Which installation I have done right away. Now, what I need to do here? I just need to enter cd media, then rhel, hit enter ls. Then here what I need to do here, copy -rf. I just need to copy packages, whatever things belongs to packages, it will copy everything from packages so that I given star. Okay, star means everything. And where I want to store? I want to store in that dump. This is the dump name. This is the locally, this is the dump name, and this dump I will give in the repository path. So here I want to copy everything. So it will take few more minutes because it will copy all the RPM packages. It will take few minutes. Have patience. Don't panic. Now it's copied, right? What we need to do here we just need to come out and we need to go /etc yum.repo. Here I can give here rhl.repo. This is my repo name, nothing else. Okay, then we need to give configure local, so I can give here local. Okay, then I need to give your name. I can give your my PC. I can give like that as well. Name anything you can give. Okay, then I need to give your base URL equal to file. Then I need to give ///, and that dump path. That dump path is nothing but var, tp, and pop, right? Then enabled equal to 1. We need to give here gpg chck equal to 0. We need to give. Then set done. Here, what we need to do now? We'll go for create a repo. Dump repo, create repo -p and var ftp and pop. This is my dump, right? Where's dump? Then hit enter. It will take here few more minutes. What it will do? It will create a dump by taking all those rpm packages, and later part when you go to install any package, it will reach this dump file where it will carry the package and it will install. So don't get panic, just wait for some time. Now, my dump repo has been created successfully, right? So what I need to do here, I just need to start the VSFTPD service. Service VSFTPD status. First we can check what is showing here. It's stop. So I can start that service VSFTPD start. Once you start, restart it for better knowing. Okay. Then if I want to start the service for permanent basis, when my system will reboot again, what it will do, this service will be run automatic. So how I will do that? By check config chk config vsftpd pd on. Now I can check how many repos are there, repo list. By yum repo list I can check how many repos are there. It will be only one repo called local repo. Local repo. See, my PC local repo is available now. Other than that, is nothing. So here, from my PC local repo, I want to install a particular package. How I'll install? I'll go for yum install. Suppose I want to install DHCP. DHCP. Okay, hit enter. Asking yes or no, so you need to give yes. Also you can give yes there itself when you will execute yum install and that particular package name. After package you can give hyphen y as well, you can give that. And if you want multiple package you want to install at a time, also you can give yum install one package name space another package name space another package name and hyphen y, like that way also you can do that. Okay, so after this installation, after this package installation, I will tell you some yum management part. See, now my DHCP installation has been completed. Getting? So this is all about the yum configuration part. Let me go ahead for the yum configure management part. So after that, if I want to make it clean, how I can make clean? Yum clean all. If we'll make yum clean all, what it will do? It will cleaning of everything, whatever thing is not required. Like sometime what it will do, package kit repo it will be storing in. If I'll execute here yum repo list, what it's showing, my PC as well as this one also, it is showing this is not required. Okay, so if you will execute yum clean all, what it will do, it will clean unnecessary things, whatever things it's storing during the yum configuration. Okay, but it will not remove any repositories. Okay, so this is what. But here now my PC was this is my local repository. This has been stored, this always it will store, no need to worry about it. But here what you need to do, when you will install any package, okay, so suppose the here we are installing by local repo, right? So what we need to do here, we just need to come cd then slash etc then yum dot repo. Here you need to execute ls here, that rm hyphen rf package git you need to remove here. Now if you come here and you'll check cd and if you check here cat slash etc yum dot repo, it will, it's a directory, right? So if you check here yum dot repo, it will show only repository. If you come here and you will type yum repo list, it will show only my PC. It will show only my PC. So just one second. It will show only my PC. Now Red Hat Enterprises Linux 6.0, this repository is not available there. Because of this repository is storing automatic, so no need to worry about it. But make sure when you are going to install any RPM package, before install RPM package, just execute yum repo list so that you will get the confirmation whether only your repo, which repo has been created recently, or a new repo is there, or apart from that some other repo is there. If apart from that some other repo is there, you can remove from here and you can store in somewhere else if you are working in the real environment. If it's normally in your local system handle, you are doing lab session, directly you can remove that auto store repositories. No need to worry about it. But for the yum clean all, why we are executing yum clean all? To remove the unnecessary files, whatever files it's creating automatically during the yum configuration. Okay, for that purpose only, we are executing yum clean all, nothing else. Apart from that, there are one more command called yum update. So if you execute this command, what it will do? It will update any new versions of package, whatever package is available in the new repo. Okay, now what is saying? No package marked for update. Okay, what is saying? No package marked for the update. Actually, this is, I mean, recently we did that, right? So we did not push any new versions of package or any new versions of RPM or any new versions of software in repositories. So that it's saying no packages are marked which need to be, which update need to be done. So let me give you an example. What we are doing in the real environment. In the real environment, what we used to do when we are going to do patch update, you will get most of the time question from the interviewer, and that's true. How we are performing patch update, the same question you will get from the interviewer. And if you don't know how, just listen my work and understand it. If still you are getting any confusion, you can write in the comment field. So here the question is, how we will update the patch, or how we are updating the patch, or how we are managing our update administration or patch administration. This is all about the question. So what we need to do here before start a patch update, okay? So you know, most of the time what we are doing, most of the time what we are doing, our servers are belongs to Denver or Oma. It depends where our client is available, okay? Where our client data center is available. In data center, there are one team called project team, some of the members, they are working the project team. What they used to do, they normally went to Red Hat site, and from the Red Hat site, they used to check what is the new versions of packages are available. Okay, once they found the new versions of packages, what they used to do, they used to download the same, and they used to put in the repositories. Okay, else what they used to do, they used to build RPM package, and those RPM package they used to push in the repository, and which repository is available in the satellite server. What suppose we are working in India, we are managing the things by remotely. Okay, so once they push RPM packages, or once they put new versions of packages in the repositories, from repositories only we can take new versions of package and we can update it. Okay, we can reach to new repositories and we can update it. So repos are, there are multiple repos. So repo would be like 1Q 2008, it means first quarter 2008, 2Q 2008, 3Q 2008, it means third quarter 2018. Okay, like that repo name would be available. So always project team, what they used to do, they used to give the fresh repo path in the yum configuration parameter. Okay, so that it will be not a problem for us when we are updating the patch. Else, if multiple repo would be there or path parameter will be not correct, so when or when will execute yum repo list, if multiple repo is new repo is there, then it will show only one repo. If multiple repo is there, then it will show multiple repo. But when in multiple repos are there, we have to remove one repo from repo parameter, and we need to store in the somewhere else if we need that. But in the real time, yes, we need that, so we should not delete anything else without any permission and all. So what we need to do here, we just need to remove this repo is not required, I mean old repo, we just need to remove here, and we need to store somewhere else. Here only one repo would be available, that repo is nothing but the fresh repo. Okay, where new versions of RPM packages would be available, which RPM package is pushed by project team guy. Okay, so here what we need to do before executing yum update hyphen y or yum update, we need to check whatever read only file systems are there. That is the first thing we need to check, whatever read only file systems are there. So how we'll check how many file systems are read only? By executing mount, we can check how many only mount, mount. By executing only mount, we can check how many read only file system, how many read write file systems are there. We just need to, our main concern is here, we just need to make note how many read only files are there. Once we check this, then we need to take the backup of important files. Okay, whatever, which important files backup is required. Take an example like var log messages, var log sqr, var log d messages, cron tab entries. Okay, and yes, this I mean this four five file systems, whichever file system is most important, we need to take backup. Once we take backup, then only we need to execute this yum update command. Once you execute yum update command, it will take few more minutes. It depends, it will take how much time it will take, it depends on the RPM package. So once it's updated successfully, it will show you complete. So once it's so complete, what we need to do here, the system will ask for the reboot. We just need to reboot that by executing init6. Okay, once we reboot everything fine, then system will come up. If something goes wrong, then system will stuck up. It may stuck up from gov or it may stuck up from kernel. It depends. Okay, if some kernel panic issue is there, then during the system will again to again it will reboot, and reboot in this, it will come to the kernel state, and from there again it will reboot. So this is called the kernel panic. What is the exact issue? The straight line would be there, right? The message line. So there only you can read and you can get to know, okay, this, if this is the case, according to that you can troubleshoot. How you will troubleshoot if kernel panic is there? Then you need to go for the Linux rescue mode. How you will go for the Linux rescue mode? I have shared this video already in the new session. You can go through that. Okay, how we are troubleshooting the part when we are facing any kernel panic issue. Okay, step by step is there. You can go through that video. So for that, you will get the clear picture. Okay, moreover that, let me mention the same as well here. Okay, when that message will come here, what we need to do, we need to again it will go for the reboot, right? So when it will reboot, before kernel take the ISO image from grub, you need to press E key. So once you press E key, then only you need to press B key. Once you press B key, then only you need to press again E key. So when you will press again E key, exactly on that screen itself, bottom, it will show boot colon. So when it will show boot colon, there you need to type Linux rescue and hit enter key. Once you type Linux rescue and hit enter key, then there have some other steps by which steps you can troubleshoot the part, and those steps is clearly mentioned in my Linux rescue session. If you'll go through that, you will understand the step by step. So if kernel panic issue is there, this is the way you can troubleshoot the part. If suppose some issue is happening for the JavaScript, what it will do, it will not boot from the kernel. So at that time, what you need to do, you need to boot the system from the old kernel. Okay, and once you boot the system from the old kernel, then only you need to go for the var log messages, then only you can check in the var d messages. Okay, by checking those things, you can get to know what is the trouble is there. So according to that, you can troubleshoot the part. If still you are not getting by reading that log files, what you need to do, there would be the some one more team who are using a tool. By that tool only they can get to know, okay, so this is the root cause. So what you need to do here, you just need to give that var log messages as well as var log d messages file to that team. So what they will do, they will take that log message and they will put in the tool only. By that tool, they will get to know this is the root cause. Then only they will share with you, this is the root cause. According to that, you can troubleshoot the part. Okay, sometime root cause, it may like on over that particular machine, on which machine you are going to do the patch update. Okay, on that machine, which application is running, which application is up and running, might be that application execution file is not related to your new versions of packages. So package installation done properly, but that application execution file is not related, it's or not matching. So what, or not reliability. So here that is the case only, your system is not coming up or your system came up, system is up and running, but their application is not up and running. For this case, what you need to do, you just need to reach that application team and you need to ask them, give us perfect execution file for the new versions of packages. So for that, we'll install first your application, then only we'll go for the repatch update. Then only your application will work properly. Else, give your credential. So for that, we'll enter in the concerned URL where we can get the source code, and we'll install that source code. By taking that source code, we'll make a I mean we'll build RPM package, and that RPM package will install. After install the RPM package, we'll go for the re-update. Okay, so this is what we can do if issue is belongs to application. If is issue is belongs to JavaScript, then we just reach to the that var log messages and var log d messages. Still, if by reading those log messages, still if you are getting, then we can trouble. If you are getting the reason, if you are getting the root cause, then we can troubleshoot the party. If you are not getting, then we need to reach to the that team, which team are handling only the log files by using a tool. We need to give that log messages to them. Then only they will put this log message in that tool. So they will try to find out the root cause. Once they found the root cause, they will tell. They will tell. This is the so and so issue. This is the so and so root cause. According to that, you can go ahead and you can troubleshoot the part. If still they are unable to find the root cause here, what you need to do, the third step is nothing but the final step, the last step. You just need to go to www.redhat.com. There you need to raise a case to Red Hat team. Once you raise a case to Red Hat team, what they will do, as soon as they will take your system remotely, and once they took your system remotely, again they will check your var log messages file only, var log message file as well as some required file. Those files they know very well whatever file is required. Okay, to check to find the root cause, they will check all those files. Once they check the files, they will come to know, okay, this is the bugs and this is the issues. If some bugs are there, they will take care about bugs. Okay, if some root different issues are there, they will let us know, this is the so and so issue, you can go ahead to troubleshoot this part. So this is what we used to do. Okay, so this is all about, you know, YUM configuration and YUM management part. Okay, so hope everybody is understand properly. If someone not understand anywhere, so I'd like to request to please give comment in the comment section, so that when I look that comment, I can briefly mention with answer, and then I can reply to you. Okay, and finally, I'd like to request to everyone, whoever following to me, please like, share, and subscribe my channel, so for that I can bring new tech solutions in front of you. By those solutions, you can troubleshoot your day-to-day activities whenever you are facing any issues. Thanks a lot, everyone.